this week, the Bulls went from working the night shift at McDonald's to then ordering Lambos just days later. Earlier in the past week, the Bears were euphoric to see the price at $34,000, and today the Bulls are euphoric to see the price near $45,000. So that begs the question, what is going to happen next? What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Kevin Svenson, and today we're going to be discussing the Bitcoin price. So Bitcoin has been making some pretty good strides recently, breaking through multiple key resistance points, and now we're testing an extremely key level, the 45,500 level. Over the past many months, Bitcoin's price has just seen lower high after lower high after lower high, so on and so forth. And now we're in a different position. Now Bitcoin is more or less sideways. One key moving average that's showing us something interesting right now is this 50-day EMA. Since November, that was the last time on the chart we actually saw higher highs. And over there, we saw that the 50 EMA was pointed upward, then curled over and down. And it has had a downward posture. This EMA has had a downward posture or downward direction. It was pointing down, well, all over for the entire past many months. And today is the first day since November that the EMA, the 50 EMA, is actually starting to point in an upward sloping direction, clearly showing that momentum could be returning back for the Bulls. And like I said earlier, you know, the Bears were euphoric at the bottom. Now today the Bulls are euphoric at the previous resistance. So the question that everyone's probably asking is it safe to be bullish now? Should we keep being bearish, right? As you guys know, just the other day on the channel, I was talking about a lot of bearish signals that historically have been accurate for calling bear markets. And one of them was actually avoided. This one, we talked about this, the 20 SMA on the monthly. We had the monthly close yesterday. And every time we close below the 20 SMA on the monthly in previous cycles, whenever we closed below it, which we did not do when we did in the past, it ushered in a major bear market, right? And yesterday, Bitcoin was testing really up to the 20 MA, and then the bulls stepped in and punched the price up and defended that 20 SMA on the monthly, defended that level. This was a key level to defend if we were going to remain bullish. So yeah, that the bulls are actually stepping in, showing that they do have some strength here. Now, just like the past two cycles, if this next month does come back down and we close below it, well, there we go. Then we have the historic bearish signal. If the bulls continue to push, well, then we won't, that signal won't show up. And we do have a shot at continuing an uptrend. So far, bulls are defending the 20 SMA, a historic bear market signal. So that's great to see on the bullish side. Another key moving average is the 50-week moving average. This is a very key one. We also discussed how in previous cycles, that was our bear market continuation signal, right? Whenever we cross below this moving average, and Bitcoin is still below it. Bitcoin is still below it. In all other cycles, when we did break down below it, like check out 2018, for instance, check this out. We break down below it, we bounce up, use it as resistance, right? Bounced up, bulls get euphoric, and then we dump. So I'm not saying that this is going to play out again. It could play out. That's why I'm mentioning it, right? If you go back in time here, you know, in this cycle, it was a little bit different. Once we broke it, we kind of just stayed below it. But like 2018, break below it, test up to it and reject. So my point here is that, you know, should we be bullish? Well, I would say not necessarily until we get this signal. And that signal is going to be one, breaking above 45,500, which may happen after I release this video. Could be very soon. Or, you know, maybe we reject. So 45,500, breaking above that, that signal number one. Signal number two is going to be breaking above this 50-week SMA. Because just like 2018, if we come up to it and reject, well, that's just another lower high, right? So if we break above it, if we can pop up above the 50-week SMA, well, there you go. That signal would then be avoided if we break above it, just like, you know, or I should say unlike previous cycles, right? If we broke back above that, well, we would avoid the signal that always ushered in a bear market in the past. So, you know, it's kind of funny, right? Bears are euphoric here, bulls are euphoric here, but we don't really have necessarily a direction yet. We go from bearish to neutral. We get about, if we get above 45.5 and the 50-week SMA, that's when, you know, as a bull, you can start to become a little bit more euphoric. Until then, it's directionless. It's kind of just sideways. And that's just the truth. That's just where we are, right? Looking at all these historic signals. But again, we could be close. I mean, we're right here, right? We're right here. It's currently almost 9 a.m., so a half hour away from the stock market open. If stocks are bullish today, maybe Bitcoin's a little bit more bullish. If stocks are bearish today, maybe Bitcoin's a little bit more bearish, right? So we'll see that, you know, it all depends. It all depends. You know, looking at this chart right now, Bitcoin over here, you know, when Bitcoin hit 30,000, the bears were euphoric, pops up, bulls are euphoric. So, you know, it looks like we might break out today. I mean, it's, you know, maybe, but, you know, you never know. I mean, you never really know what kind of action is going to come in after a pump like that. I mean, it would be a lot of fun to see Bitcoin kind of just rip up, but we'll see, right? We will see, guys. So that is it for this video. Hope this helped you guys maybe understand the conditions that I'm looking for us to call direction here in this market. Maybe helps guide you through this move, and I'll see you all in the next video.